people would bring up your past. Well, may I share with you, every one of us sitting in here is ex something. The Lord deliver us from something. Now your story may not be mine, and my story may not be yours. What I have been delivered from may not be what you have been delivered from. But deliverance ain't no more than deliverance. And if you've been delivered or being delivered, lift your hands and shout hallelujah. Because I believe God is a God of a second chance. And so what we've got to do is not get stuck on how people see us. David puts it this way: Lord, you judge me and don't turn me in the hands of my enemies. And sometimes you got to look to God and say, you deal with me. Don't put me in the hands of people. And then David also says, he says, listen, don't confuse my actions with my desires. I wish I had me a church. Sometimes life causes us to act one way, but our desire is to be something else. And so David says, one thing will I desire, that will I seek after. He said, I don't care what life's throw me in, I'm going to stay in the house of the Lord. Can you grab the hands of the hand of somebody that says, I'm not walking out of the church. I don't care how much time you get knocked down, you just got to get up, brush yourself off, and start again. I wish I had me a church. Sometimes you want to get knocked down, don't stay on the ground. Everybody stuck your foot and say, I'm not staying on the ground. I'm not staying on the ground. See, I'm preaching in the Bahamas. You are counting how many times I go down, but you better count my ability to get back up. I wish I had me a church here. For the Bible says, though a good man fall, I gotta take my time, yet will he rise. Can you high five two persons and says, listen, I'm gonna get on my feet again. I'm gonna get on my feet again. I don't care what is going on. You may be experiencing financial difficulties. The Holy Ghost sent you here this morning for me to tell you, favor is looking for you. I wish I had near praise, and it's only a test. Come on, I just need a praise right here. I gotta pause and give God a praise, because somebody is about to walk in divine favor. Well, be seated. God gave me this word in January. In January, I promise I'm not going to keep it too long. When the year come in, Apostle Thompson, he said to me, 2015 is the year of divine benefits. Divine benefits. Look at your neighbor and say, benefits. Mm-hmm. And I said, Lord, what you mean by benefits? He said, son, if you own a job, sometimes the salary is not good, but you keep that job because it got good benefits. I wish I had a witness. And then he said, when you look at it, benefit is not what you have to wait for. Benefits is what you have already worked for. He said, so when you get in genuine love this morning, tell them, I say, they are in the season of benefits. Benefits is what you deserve. Benefit is what they can't keep from you. Can you shake two person hand on your roof and say, I'm in my benefit season. I'm in my season of benefits. What I have already worked for. Some of you have already struggled. You've already cried. You've already went through your rough days. Can I talk to you? And God said to go there this morning and tell them, be a prophetic people. The struggle is over. I wish I had me a praise here. Somebody lift your hands and touch two person. High five somebody on your roof and say, the struggle is over. My crying days is over. My days of just enough is over. Watch this. Sit down. Sit down. Give me a few seconds. Watch this. And you got to understand what God, the season God is bringing you in. When God says, or the Bible says, you shall be the lender and not the borrower. Now, if I'm going to be the lender, I have to have more than I need. I cannot have only what I need, because if I've got only what I need, it is ludicrous, it is stupid, it is crazy to give you, and I've only got what I need. So if God expects me to be the lender, he's got to give me more than enough. And about 17 of you is going to get more than enough. I hear the Lord says, welcome to your week of miracle. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to give him a praise. Well, let's go to this. And so watch this. And so